Good morning, my dear students. Welcome to the discussion on the topic projection of plane inclined to both the planes. Under this, we are discussing now 8th solid problem. Now we'll enter into the problem. The given problem is a circular plate of negligible thickness and 60 mm diameter appears as an ellipse in the front view, having its major axis 60 mm long and minor axis 40 mm long. Draw its top view when the major axis of the ellipse is horizontal. Now we'll extract the data from the problem. The name of the plane is circular plate with 60 mm diameter. The circular plate appears as a ellipse in the front view, so its major axis length is 60 mm long and minor axis length is 40 mm long. For initial position of the plate, how we have to consider that we'll see now. A circle can be seen as ellipse in the front view only when its surface is inclined to VP. So for the first view, keep the plane parallel to the VP. That is, in this case, the circular plane is assumed to be parallel to VP. So the true image falls onto the vertical plane. That is, assumption for initial position is the plane is parallel to VP. This is related to the first stage solution. Then we'll consider the surface inclination of the plane. That is second stage solution. Then third stage solution is nothing but keeping the major axis of the ellipse horizontal. This is third stage solution. Now we'll move towards in detail solution related to the given problem. Before drawing the detailed solution for the given problem, now we'll see initial position assumption. In the problem, it is mentioned that the circular plate appears as a ellipse in the front view. When the circular plate appears as a ellipse in the front view, when the circular plate makes an angle 5 degrees to the VP, then only it appears as a ellipse in the front view. That is, a circle can be seen as a ellipse in the front view only when its surface is inclined to VP. So for initial position assumption, neglect the surface inclination to VP so that the circular plane is parallel to VP. That is, for initial position assumption, we are assuming the circular plate is parallel to the VP and perpendicular to the HP, so that we will get true image on the vertical plane. Now we'll move towards detailed solution related to the given problem. The detailed solution related to the given problem is divided into three stages. Stage 1, plane parallel to VP. Stage 2, considering the surface inclination to VP till the distance between the end projectors become 40 mm. Then stage 3, incline the front view so that the major axis becomes horizontal. That is, first stage, plane parallel to VP. Second stage, considering the surface inclination to VP till the distance between the end projectors is 40 mm. As in the problem, it is given that the length of the minor axis of the ellipse is 40 mm. Then stage 3, incline the front view so that the major axis becomes horizontal. Now we'll enter into the stage 1 solution. As a first step in stage 1, draw XY line. After that, as we assumed that the circular plate is parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. So draw front view of a circular plate of diameter 60 mm on vertical plane. Front view is a circle. Its diameter is 60 mm. After that, divide the circle into 12 equal parts and name the division points as 1', 2', 3', etc. etc. After that, Draw projectors through division points on the front view of a circle, say 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, etc., towards the horizontal plane. The projectors are meeting the horizontal plane at different points, namely 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. After that, name those points, then join those points. Here 1 to 7 line is there, no? This line is nothing but top view of a circular plate when it is parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. This 1 to 7 is the top view image of a circular plate in initial position. With this we completed stage 1 solution. Now we'll move towards stage 2 solution. Stage 2. Now we'll see the demonstration of the stage 2 solution. In the problem, it is mentioned that in the second stage, the circle appears as a ellipse in front view with major axis 60 mm long and minor axis 40 mm long. How we'll get the ellipse with those dimensions? That we'll see now. Tilt the initial stage circle with inclination to VP till the minor axis of the ellipse becomes 40 mm. That means after tilting the circle with inclination to the VP, then the vertical line measurement may not change, only the horizontal line measurement is to be reduced to 40 mm. So draw 40 mm line. After that, draw projectors towards the horizontal plane. This is the length of the minor axis. After drawing the projectors from the two ends of a minor axis towards the horizontal plane, then take the top view length in the initial stage as a radius on this projector, say at this particular point as a center, and top view length as a radius, draw an arc on this projector, then it is the second stage top view. After that, we need to draw second stage front view. How we will draw second stage front view? That second stage front view is obtained with reference to the second stage top view and first stage front view. So with that, we'll get ellipse shape like this. That is, its major axis length is 60 mm and minor axis length is 40 mm. How we'll get this in detail, we'll see now. As a first step in stage 2, what we need to do? Draw locus lines for 1 dash as well as 7 dash. After drawing the locus line, then locate 1-1 dash as well as 7-1 dash so that the distance between 1-1 dash and 7-1 dash is equal to length of the minor axis of a ellipse, which is equal to 40 mm. After that, draw projectors vertically down towards the horizontal plane from 1-1 dash as well as 7-1 dash. After that, take top view length as a radius, then locate a point on this projector, say here, then with that radius, draw an arc on the second projector. This is second stage top view, then transfer the remaining points, say 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. on this second stage top view. After that, draw a projector through 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 towards the vertical plane and draw locus lines through 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, etc. towards right. That is, drawing projectors through second stage top view and drawing locus lines through first stage front view is over. Then we locate the intersection points and name those intersection points also. After that, join all these points in a sequential order with the help of a smooth curve. The smooth curve is the required ellipse in the front view. The smooth curve is the required ellipse in the front view with minor axis length 40 mm and major axis length 60 mm. With this, we completed second stage solution. Now we'll move towards third stage solution. In the case of stage 3, what we need to do? We need to draw the major axis of the ellipse as horizontal. For that, what we need to do here, this is the ellipse in the second stage solution. This is the minor axis length of the ellipse and this is the major axis length of the ellipse. Now what we need to do? Rotate the second stage front view so that the major axis of the ellipse becomes horizontal. After that, draw third stage top view, that is final top view, with reference to the third stage front view and second stage top view. How you are going to draw the final top view, that we'll see now. Here, the distance between two points, say 41 dash as well as 101 dash, is nothing but length of the major axis of ellipse. And distance between two points, say 11 dash and 71 dash, is nothing but the length of the minor axis of the ellipse. In the third stage, what we need to do? We need to draw the major axis of the ellipse as horizontal. For that, what we need to do? Draw a line parallel to XY line. After that, locate a point 101 dash on this line. Then 41 dash also on this line, so that the gap between 101 dash and 41 dash is equal to length of the major axis, that is 60 mm. Then at the middle of the 41 dash as well as 101 dash, draw a perpendicular line 11 dash, 71 dash. Here 11 dash and 71 dash is the minor axis of the ellipse line. Then in the second stage front view, 21 dash and 121 dash line is intersecting the 11 dash and 71 dash line here, and 31 dash and 111 dash line is intersecting the 11 dash and 71 dash line here. Then 51 dash and 91 dash line is intersecting the 11 dash and 71 dash line here. Then 61 dash and 81 dash line is intersecting the 11 dash and 71 dash line here. So these points we locate on this third stage minor axis line. Then through these points, draw lines parallel to 41 dash as well as 101 dash. Here, this is the line related to the 21 dash as well as 121 dash, and this is the line related to the 31 dash as well as 111 dash, and this is the line related to the 51 dash as well as 91 dash, and this is the line related to the 61 dash as well as 81 dash. Now here, with compass, 11 dash, 21 dash as a radius, 11 dash as a center, draw an arc on this parallel line. Similarly, 11 dash, 31 dash as a radius, 11 dash as a center, draw an arc on this parallel line. Similarly, 11 dash, 121 dash as a radius, 11 dash as a center, draw an arc on this parallel line. 11 dash, 111 dash as a radius, draw an arc on this parallel line. Similarly, repeat the procedure for getting the remaining points. After that, number these points, say 21 dash, 31 dash, etc., and join all these points in a sequential order. After giving the numbering to the intersection points, then join all these points in a sequential order. Then we got ellipse in the front view with its major axis, say 101 dash and 41 dash, is parallel to the XY line. With this, we completed drawing third stage front view. Then we'll draw Thursday's top view. How you will draw Thursday's top view? Through division points on the ellipse in the third stage front, you say 1-1 dash, 2-1 dash, 3-1 dash, etc. Draw projectors vertically down. Then from the second stage top view points, namely 1, 2, 3, etc., draw locus lines. Then locate the intersection points. Locate the intersection points here. After locating the intersection points in the third stage top view, give numbering to these points and join all these points in a sequential order. After numbering the intersection points in the third stage top view, join all these points in a sequential order with the help of a smooth curve. This is the final stage top view. Here 10-1 and 4-1 is the length of the major axis, and 10-1 dash and 4-1 dash is the length of the major axis. Here 10-1 dash and 4-1 dash in front view, 10-1 and 4-1 in top view, both these lines are parallel to the XY line. That means the major axis of the ellipse is horizontal. This is the first stage solution. Here the plane is parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. And this is the second stage solution. In this stage, we are going to incline the first stage top view such that the end projector distance becomes 40 mm. That is going to be the length of the minor axis of the ellipse. Then in the case of third stage, we are going to tilt this front view such that the major axis, that is 4-1 dash, 10-1 dash, becomes horizontal in the third stage front view. Here the diameter of the circular plate is 60 mm and length of the major axis of the ellipse is 60 mm and length of the minor axis of the ellipse is 40 mm. Here all these dimensions are in millimeters. So that's about the solution related to the given problem. Visit again for more videos on engineering graphics using the links provided under description of this video. Keep learning and knowledge sharing. Thank you for watching.